previously, we looked at using some of MATLAB's built-in functions. And in this series of lectures, we're going to look at making our own functions for MATLAB to use. Now, first, I want to start with a little bit about the terminology we're going to use here when we're dealing with functions. Really, a function is something that takes an argument or arguments, does some manipulation to them, and then produces an output or multiple outputs. For example, last week, we looked at the function sine d, and let's refresh on how that works. Now remember, sine d is going to take an angle measure, specifically in degrees, and then give us the sine of that angle measure. So for example, if I look at sine d of 45, it's going to give me 0.7071, which is the sine of 45 degrees. So here, the sine d is the function. It takes one argument, the 45, and then produces, in this case, one output, the 0.7071. We also saw functions that took multiple arguments. So if we look at another function like linspace that we use to produce some of our evenly spaced vectors, this could take three arguments. So for example, our first argument was the starting number, the last number was the ending number, and then the third argument was how many elements to have between the first number and the last number. So in this case, if I try 50, it gives me an output that's a vector that's going to be 50 elements long. There's a lot we can do with the built-in functions in MATLAB, but MATLAB also lets us make our own functions, as long as we follow a couple of rules for making them. So if we want to make our own function, like sine or sine d, or like linspace, we're going to make an M file that contains the definition of our function. So I'm going to make a new script here, and to tell it that I want it to act like a function rather than a script like we looked at last time, I'm going to start with the word function. Now I'm going to make a function here that's going to convert from degrees in Celsius to degrees in Fahrenheit for me. So what I do on the left-hand side here is this is where I'm going to mark the output or outputs of my function. In this case, I'm going to have one output that I'm going to call F, which is my degrees in my temperature in Fahrenheit. I'm going to call this function, I'll call it C2F. Notice here that the name of our function has to follow the same type of rules that our variable names do. So it can't start with a number, and we don't want it to have the same name as a built-in function in MATLAB. And in this case, the capitalization is going to matter. So I'm going to call my function capital C2F, or converting Celsius to degrees in Fahrenheit. And the argument it's going to take, I'm going to call capital C, which is going to be my temperature as measured in Celsius. So in this example here, I'm going to have one output F and one input C. And while I'm working on this, I want to give this a description here. So this is going to convert degrees C to degrees F. And I'm going to save this. And the name of the M file has to be the same as the name of the function. So by default, when you save it, it will give it that same name, but they have to match, so if you change one, you have to change the other. All right, so I'm going to save this. And now you'll see that if I type help for the function I just invented, C to F, it tells me that comment that I put in line 2. It converts degrees C to degrees F. So we made also our own little help definition for this function. All right, so what I want is I want to take my one argument, C, do manipulation to it, and get my output, F. So the formula here I'm going to use is that my temperature in degrees Fahrenheit, which I will call big F, is going to be my input C times 9 over 5 plus 32. I'm going to suppress that. And this is an optional step, but I think it's a good habit that at the end of your function, you're going to type the word return, and that tells MATLAB that that's the end of the function. I'm going to resave this. I'm going to clear my screen here, clear everything I have going here, and now I can see how I can use my function. So I can use it similar to how I used the built-in functions. So say I wanted to convert 25 degrees Celsius to Fahrenheit. I can use my function I just made, C to F, 25. And that tells me that in Fahrenheit, 25 degrees C is 77 degrees Fahrenheit. And if it's 0 degrees Celsius, it's going to give me 32 degrees Fahrenheit. And just one more, if I have 100 degrees or boiling point of water, I get 212 degrees Fahrenheit. I can modify the function I just made to give me a little bit more value out of it. I'm going to keep it with converting from degrees Celsius, but I can actually give this two outputs. I'm going to have it not only give me the degree conversion in Fahrenheit, but also the degree conversion in Kelvin. And I'll modify my help file to reflect this. So I still have that one input argument, C, but now I'm going to get two output arguments, F and K. So I'm going to keep my definition for F. Now to compute my degrees in Kelvin, I'm going to take my degrees in Celsius and add 273.15 to that. All right, so let's see how this differs. Let me clear the screen here. If I use it, my function, the way that I was just previously using it, by default, it only gives me the first output, which in this case is F. But I can use this in a different way where I can save my two outputs here. I'll call it, just to prevent confusion here, little f and little k. And I'll say that that's equal to C to F of 100. And what we see here is that it now saves, if we look at the workspace, we have f, little f saved as 212, my conversion in Fahrenheit, and little k I have 373.15, or my conversion in Kelvin. If I do this again, let's say at 0 degrees, again I have f at 32, and my value in Kelvin, I get 273.15. Here I've been using it just in the command line, but I can also use the new function in a script file. So I'm going to go to another M file. This is called a script because I can just run it without having to supply arguments. You see, if we go to the function file we just made, if I try to hit run here, it's not going to let me do that. We can't run the function without the argument in here. So what I'm trying to do is run it like I ran a script last time. But here I can't do that. If I go to my script file, I can run this just like I did last time. So in this case, I will do similar to what I just did in the command line below. I'll use my new function, C to F, at 100 degrees. And I won't suppress it for right now. So if we see here, again, it saved a value of 212 in F and a value of 373 in little k. I can also use my function not only supplying a scalar value, but the way that I've defined it, it's also able to handle vectors. So if we look here, I'm putting in to my argument 0 and 100, or the vector 0 and 100, and if I run this, it now saves my conversion from Celsius of 0 and 100 into Fahrenheit, 32 and 212, and in K, it saved two values, 273 and 373. And as before, I can feed it numbers from 0 to 100 separated by ones. And now I have F and K, each with 101 values, the conversion of Celsius to Fahrenheit at all the values of Celsius, 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 100.